Hello everybody and welcome to Train Simulator 2014. This is a career mode, it's a let's play, and I'm your host, Jack Wall. It looks like I've reached level 5 through crazy accidental mishappenstance, or whatever the phrase would be. I've got 2559 XP, but I've probably lost just as many points over the course of the last, what appears to be 9 attempted scenarios. I've completed 8 of them. I've got 2 gold medals and 3 bronze, so overall it sounds a hell of a lot better than it actually is, but we're getting there, and that's the whole aspect of this game, to deal with the challenges that come. So we're about to do a bit of a long run here. There's one ICE2, or Intercity Express, ICE2, that I can't appear to do because I don't seem to have the appropriate route downloaded, so that's kind of not going to happen. I did quite enjoy my class 466 networker, and I really did enjoy the Deutsche Bahn BR101, so I'm considering doing another one of these. This one here, being a little bit more demanding, it's a freight service, and it's running from Veddel siding to Unterlüß. So I'm really not sure what's involved with that, and I'm a little bit tentative about doing it. There's the ever infamous Frostfall that needs to be corrected at some point in time, and there's also some what appear to be freight maneuvers between Hamburg and Hanover again with a class 294 Deutsche Bahn. I'm not sure what AG stands for, but it's a red locomotive. Somebody may inform me what that stands for a little bit later. This is shunting duties in and around Hamburg and Veddel docks, but I think the one that I'm going to do is this southbound freight between Hamburg and Hanover. We will be learning as we go along with this one, so I'm going to have to ask for your patience. And yeah, we'll see what happens. So I'll bring... Okay, well, welcome back in. Here we go. This morning you're tasked with driving the intermodal freight service to Unterlüß, Klaus Fumpf, stopping at Aschhausen, I don't know. Bartovic and Deutsche Bahn in order to allow higher priority trains to pass. We'll turn on a light, we'll click OK, and I guess we'll take our brake off, set forward motion, and get ourselves moving out. We've got a pretty long train here. This is the back of it here. And there's no kind of mark on the back of it, which is a bit odd. I thought they'd put a triangle or something on the back of it. But maybe that's not in every country. But we're a good long train, we're full of containers, and there's our aeroplane view as we move on out, nice and steady, and here's a view of us, there we go, I was looking over here at the red trains, there's a view of us from above, as we're gently accelerating our way. Heading on down the line, we have 22 kilometers and 400 meters to get to Aschhausen, and yeah, and there's a weird view, but that's engine 1, engine 2, we're already accelerating, I don't really want to do much more than that. We have a lot of containers that are running along there, nice and gently as we're moving out. Okay, so this is a view of us as we kind of snake our way across the tracks and get through the train, so you can see the engines pulling up ahead as we go across the bridge. And here we are in the cab. Now we're on a 40 zone, but we're about to jump up to a 60 here. As usual, I don't know where the lights are inside the cab here. Can't seem to find them anywhere. I've been kind of trying to look around for these lights for a while, but there it breaks. I kind of like this cab. It's similar to the class from the last video. Those of you who know your trains are going to cringe now, but it's similar to the red one that I drove the last video. That's kind of how I'm remembering it. The train. What kind of train was it, Jack? Well, it was red. Yeah, I know. Pretty not cool, but anyway. We're going to get to run up to 60, which is, I don't know how fast freight trains get to go. I can't see us doing 220, but we get to burn some more amps, heat up those wires, and push her up to 60. And look how speedily she can accelerate. It's pretty dang fast. Let's just bring it down to kind of a maintenance percentage input of 10% is too much, 3 or 4% might be enough for steady state holding. Gentle climb at 4%, but 2% might be okay then. Yeah, 2% is just she's just holding on 2%, give or take. She's dancing on 59 kilometers an hour. Maybe losing out ever so slightly, but I'm gonna make it 3%. She's pulling a total of 9 amps just to hold steady state, so the balance point is 9.46 amps. Or just a little under 9.46 amps, because we're climbing in speed ever so little. That's kind of interesting, isn't it? I'm a total professional, of course. This is the inside of our train cab, and I'm kind of liking the outside of this part, though, because look at it, it's just this big, strong, powerful black engine, basically. Two of them. No, there's two of them. Well, we are pulling quite a lot of carriage and quite a lot of containers, so yeah, I guess we do need to have those two engines up front, but that might explain our ability to accelerate as well, because there's quite a bit of input going in there. She's a noisy old beast, though, I have to say. But that's all good. We've got a green light on our rail, so we are good to go, and it looks like we're getting up to a 120 region, which is kind of interesting. Dynamic brakes, we have locomotive brakes, and we have train brakes. I guess there are engine brakes. Okay. We haven't picked up any automatic warning systems, but there's the 120 speed advisory that we can do, and that concurs with the train passing it. Now, in the real world, should I not be able to begin my acceleration at this stage? Is my question. In the game, I can't until now, and now I can at freedom. But until that speed limit changes on the HUD, if I accelerate, then I'm probably breaking the speed limit and incurring some penalties. And there is no indication on the console, so I guess in the real world it would be down to the train driver knowing exactly what the track is and what's going on. I've noticed up ahead, because of the HUD, there is a 100 speed limit coming up. So I've decided that I would knock off at 99 or 98. I've got my 2 or 3% maintenance power in there, and here's the warning coming up for 100. 10 times 10, multiply those numbers by 10. So that 100 is coming up after the lights, about a third of a mile, just the other side of the bridge. Or maybe the 100 is because of the bridge, actually. Yeah, it is. There's the 100 marks just before the bridge. So the bridge has a speed limit, probably because of some frequencies on the bridge. There's a, I guess that's a road bridge on the other side. Huh. Water is pretty okay, I guess, in the game. It's not awesome, though. The water in, we got some speeding to reduce 8 times 10 is 80. My maths is amazing, but we need to slow down to 80. And we have a warning period, but we're going to come up on that 80 in just a little over half a mile, or half a kilometer. So we're applying some 22% brake against our 3% drive, so yeah, I'll just take the brake off of that, and we'll leave the 3% there as our maintenance. 9.2 amps in allows us to maintain our speed. 15 kilometers to go, scheduled for 8:15 a.m. Estimated now at 8:14 and 25. Actual is 8:03, so we have a little over 11 minutes to get to Aschhausen. Maybe it's Aschhausen. That sounds a bit better than Aschhausen. Chuckle. Funny. Haha. We'll throw in another 9 or so amps and keep our speed steady eddy. This is another view as we schmooze our way on down the line. That's quite a nice view, actually. Lovely focus in on the Deutsche Bahn logo, and yeah, that's kind of a decent view of our train going down the line, and it just flicks around to different views as you go, and this is pretty decent. This view is kind of gets a bit dumb in the middle, but then you get to see the train passing out underneath you, which is good. We have gone up to a 120 zone, so I shall apply a little bit more power. And there's another focus in on the Deutsche Bahn 101047-9. We have a 60 coming up, though, so I don't think I really want to bother doing much more. It's about 2 kilometers up. And, yeah. Yeah, nothing at the back telling me that I'm a train. But I'm a good big long one. Alrighty then, so 12.3 kilometers to go, and we do probably need to keep a little bit tighter to the speed limit. Just looking at our estimated, we don't really have very much to spare. We're basically on 8:15 estimated, which is still okay, but we have some 11.6 kilometers still to go, so ain't convinced. Now that's a 6 warning. Did you see that on the pole? It was there. So I need to start throwing in quite a bit of brake. And so we'll get all 2 engines throwing brake in. I don't know how they link them together, but they must do it somehow. And I don't think I've passed the actual 60 marks yet, so that's okay. But we are down into the region of 60 now, so I'm just going to let it run out that last little bit. There's no real need to go down too much below. I guess with a freight train, as much as the schedule is important with a passenger train, it's more important with the freight, because if they're using the same lines, they've got to really be out of the way of the passenger trains that are coming through, right? And it's easy to say, but not necessarily easy to do. There's a view of our train as we're switching track. And we're switching track again. Let's look out the other window just to see the other side of that. That's pretty sweet. So we're maintaining our 60 as we head down here. We're under 10 kilometers now to destination, or to first stop. But it feels a little bit kind of slow here, but we're passing a lot of switches, and I don't suppose that we can really afford to go much faster than 60. And I know these rails are big, heavy-duty iron jobs, but there's hundreds of tons that are passing over them. They really do take a beating. Okay, now we do have 120, which I didn't see because I was probably too busy looking around. So we shall accelerate to as much as we can before we need to slow down again, although it looks like we've got a couple of kilometers to go. So we shall take full advantage of that. Yeah, this HUD now would be... Oh, no, cancel, just keep on. I don't know what the controls for the HUD are. There they are. That's pretty nice view of the train without the HUD. Need to check back and see, am I accelerating too much? Got quite a bit of momentum underneath me, but I seem to be okay. Yeah, and we do have a 60 coming up, so back into the HUD and up cinema graphics, and we shall start slapping on some brake, because I've literally got to slow down. There's the 6 mark, that's the warning. So I've kind of really got to, I've got 40 to drop off fairly aggressively here. I've got a kilometer to do it in, so I'm good. And I don't know if the game replicates realistic braking distances. But I'm pretty sure that it's a pretty slow procedure and you have to start fairly early on in order to get it down. We are beginning to lose a little bit of time. Our estimated has crept up to 15:44. Our schedule is 8:15, of course, so we're a little bit behind already. It says 120, but it was slowing me down to 60, and I have a little bit to go still. So I'm kind of losing time here. If I was doing 65 or 70, I might be saving myself a little bit more, but I don't know. Not necessarily all enough to make a big deal out of. So we are heading ourselves over here to cross over the lane. You can see ourselves staking across on there. The amount of stress on those switches must be pretty high. Now, how are we doing? Well, I've got an 80 coming up. I'm kind of maxing out my 60 speed limit here at the moment. I can't really do very much more. .815 is 4 minutes and 30 seconds away to do 5 kilometers. So at 60 kilometers an hour, I'm doing a kilometer a minute, which would mean I've got 5 and 3 quarter minutes to go, which would put me over into the 8:16:40 kind of region at the moment. So that is kind of what it is. And we are kind of, well, we bounce off of that and go off again down here. Wow. I have no idea where we're going, do we? Do I? Well, we have an 80 coming up, so I need to really take full advantage of that that opportunity. Just to try and keep my time under some sensible control. That's the 80 warning mark that my engine has just passed, but you'll notice that there's a delay between my HUD speed limit registering this speed and actually doing it. At the moment it looks like we're going downhill ever so slightly because I've increased in speed a little bit and incurred my first, oh, for God's sakes, I've incurred my first speeding fine, 24 points, but it wouldn't be me driving unless I incurred a speeding fine, would it? And it's that little mismatch in the game HUD between that and what's on the rails. Now maybe somebody who's a train driver or who has knowledge that I don't can explain to me what the rules really are. You know, do you have to know how far past the sign you need to go for your last carriage to pass it before you accelerate? Or, you know, whatever. Now, it looks like we've picked up some indicators here on speed, and I have a 160. Or do I? No, I have an 80. Okay, it says 160 here. It's dropping me back down to 80. Confused I am. Let's just push it. I'm supposed to be slowing down. Oh god, no, 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 no. That was a bad decision. Oh, Jesus. It's going to hell in a handbasket again. And it was going so well, right? 174, 184. Bugger, I think it was the French. Minus 182, minus 212 points total. Whippy, yippy, frickin' yappy, dappy, yahooey. I suppose I should have looked at my distance to travel. I just got all carried away on... Oh, I can make up some of the time here. Yippee, yeah, because I'm 16-16 estimated now. Oh, shut up. I'm fucking slowing down, for God's sakes. Yeah, and it's showing me 120, and it's like... Oh, man. Do I have to do anything here? I just have to stop, I think. Shit. 212 negative points because I took a moment and thought, right, I'm good, I know what I'm doing, everything's under some sense of mad control. And it's giving me 120 zone here, right? But it's not 120 at all. Or if it is, I don't believe it. And if I am to speed up, which is pointless because I need to stop, I'm only going to incur speed limits anyway because anything above 80 is not allowed. So this HUD here, I'm not a fan of, and, you know, that may be because I don't know what I'm doing. Okay, that's probably the real reason, but, you know, it should be more transparent, and it should be more easy to understand. So, Railworks, consider yourself informed. Not that anybody from Railworks is ever going to see this video. But now there's an 8 up there, which is warning me that it's an 80 zone, and I'm doing 48, so we can do 60 or something and try and split the difference here a little bit. Don't really see any point in moseying in any faster or any slower than we need to. But we do need to pull over somewhere at a siding, so at this rate I think I'll begin my slowdown. Because we are a third of a mile away from the beginning of the platform, I can see it here now. And we're arriving kind of on time. It's going to be 16 by the time we get on platform. And by all accounts, I need to come to a stop here. It's not so clear. Yeah, shut up. We're done. We're fine. At 40, I can start to apply fairly serious brake now here and just run this in because I'm bigger than... I need to stop before the lights, basically, and at 30 with that... Jesus, it's going to be... it's going to be just about, I think. So... 12... 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 3, 2, I wasn't watching it, but we have come to a stop. Right, well, the thing has started for some reason. Apparently I'm doing 0.1 kilometers an hour still. There's a time penalty of... Oh no, I'm on time. That came up as a time penalty of plus. So it's put me in back into the positive of some 19 points after all of that. My departure from Aschhausen is 20. So if I leave too early, I think I'm in trouble, right? I have to wait until 20 before I leave, right? I'm actually moving backwards. That would have accounted for the 0.01 movement. So my departure is 20, so I need to wait here, if I understand this correctly, until 20 comes up. All of the people are wondering, I can't find the door, I don't know how to get on the train. Sorry to the German people for that ridiculously stupid accent. But, as perhaps you know by now, or perhaps you don't, I only take the piss out of the people that I kind of like. And I kind of like the Germans. I kind of like everybody, actually. I'm one of these, everybody's okay, unless you piss me off, and then you're not okay, but, I mean, that's obvious, right? Alright, so, let's have a look at the back. So I'm that far off the off the platform, and pretty long old bus, haven't I? Right. Well, we have a minute and a half before we can move out, and then we have 17 kilometers to travel, and we will have a little bit with 11 minutes to do it in. And I think I should have left. I think. Oh no, you see, I shouldn't, because if I had left, I would have been ahead of this train, and then I would have been in awful trouble. But now that that train is gone, now I think I can move out. I think. Should I go? I don't know what to do. There could be another train coming down the line. I don't know what to do. I'm going to wait till the 20. That's what it says. That's what I'm going to do. It's only another, like, 40 seconds anyway. But I think that was the train, yeah, because look, the tracks go back out here. Just after the bridge, they merge back in. Right, so there's, like, 25 seconds to go as of now. So I'm going to wait and try and do the right thing here. Yeah, I feel like that was the right thing to do. Forward momentum, and we will just push out now with 3 seconds to go. And have a look behind us, and we don't have anything. We're looking good. Okay. Officially, the horn is stupid sounding. And yeah, look, we are actually merging out onto that rail that that the express was going down, so it is a good deal that we actually held our station for the length of time we did. Now, our arrival is 8:36 at Bardwick. I'm speeding again. Fuck. Well, there goes all my hard work. It says 200, man. 130. I'm no way near any of these numbers, whichever one is accurate. I'm kind of tempted to believe the 130 before the 200. Dope. Minus 11 again. Dope. Everything was going so well. Yeah, it's no way near 200. It's 130. There's 160 coming up here, and I don't think we're going to accelerate to 200 that quickly. Or if it is a 200 zone, it's not for me. So, we'll just sit it on 100 and that. Do you reckon it could be a 200? No, because it's showing 160 here, it's showing 130 there, and it's showing 200 here. I mean, really. What is a guy supposed to do? I mean, it's play safe and go with the lowest, which is what I'm doing. I mean, that's, I don't know if that's wrong or right, but it's not very comfortable. I don't quite like it. I mean, that was showing a 160 there, which is now showing a 160 here. It's still showing a 130 on that. I have a green light, I believe. Yeah, I do. It's a red light on the other rail. I'm taking a risk here now. I'm going to go a couple above the 130 and see, does she go ballistic? And she's not going ballistic yet, so... Well, that's complaining about something, because I'm over the 130, so it is... Oh, God, don't understand. We do have a 200 coming up, it says, but I'm kind of not sure I even believe that either. It's actually, it's really frustrating. But I will learn it, of course. But I learn what to do, as opposed to necessarily understand what to do, what to follow correctly. Now it's reporting 200. But it's going to start blowing its horn at me again, look. Yeah, it just doesn't want me to... I'm... Like, it's a 160 coming up here, but it's 130. I'm pegged at 130, basically, so... So I'm just going to have to drive the 130. We have 10 kilometers to go. And at 130, I'm doing basically 2 kilometers per minute. A little over 2 kilometers per minute, so I'm 5 minutes away, which brings me in on time. So I'm okay. I'm arriving at 31 and departing at 36, so... I should be okay. The arrival at 31, I think, is the critical one. It's the critical time to try and meet. That gets me ahead of possibly another intercity or priority train. And probably gives me a little bit of buffer. So if I arrived at 32, I would probably still be okay. But I would have eaten into my buffer zone, my buffer time, which if I eat too much into, then the risks start to grow of potential collision, because the guy behind, unless he's aware, is going to be shoving on to his schedule, right? So I don't know what kind of buffer times there are there, you know, kind of... I can be a little bit late on my schedule, but still I'm within the safety of the buffer time. As in, the other train is not going to arrive anyway for another 4 or 5 minutes anyway. So there's automatic warning systems going off here. I'm hitting the Q button to get rid of those. I do have a 60 coming up, it says, but I'm not going to brake just yet, because I think I'm a long way off. I'm 2.5 kilometers away from that 60. I'd like to be doing 200. But I don't think I'm allowed to do 200. So we'll do a little bit more to the 130 mark. Just to get ourselves pushing on down the line. So our schedule is 8:31:28. Our estimated is 8:30:31 at the moment, and our actual time is 8:26:09. So we're doing okay. We have 5 kilometers to go at 130. That's about 2.5 minutes. So we're looking pretty good. My math is not accurate. I'm just doing round numbers here. Kind of estimations of close to 60 kilometers an hour is 1 kilometer a minute, and if I have 60 kilometers to do, it'll take me an hour. It's kind of straightforward and obvious. Well, 120 is twice that, so I do 2 minutes, two kilometers every minute. So with 4 kilometers to go, I'm 2 minutes out, so that brings me in fairly comfortably. I'm actually a little bit ahead of time. I also believe that I've got a little over 2.5 kilometers of track to travel before I'm going to run into the next significant speed restriction. I can't believe I've just got 11 minus points again. Jesus. Sham. Alrighty then. So there's our 60 coming up at 2.5. So it kind of makes sense to... we are 2 kilometers out, but I'll just start knocking off some of the speed here now. Bring ourselves down comfortably. That's a kind of a nice view. We focus in on Deutsche Bahn. And there's an express on the other rails going by, so we'll throw in a little bit more brake here now because we are pulling over here. And we possibly have to switch in to, you know, a platform track. I guess it's going to be another express that we're letting through. There is a 60, there's a 6 showing up there. Okay, I come on, that's not fair. I mean, it's accurate and you're just being brutal, but I was one and slowing down, you know. Now I think we're probably transitioning on this switch over to the right, and yeah, we are too. Freaking get nothing for free with this game, do you? Yeah, so we just, we take the brake off now. We don't need to slow down anymore for a little while. And we will just make sure that we're coming in. Clear track up front. Last of the train is not in yet. We're still clear up front. Still the train is turning in. Jesus, we're pretty long. I think that's the last one, isn't it? It's grey. No. Man, are we able to get in? That's the last one. That one's grey. I think. Yeah, we're in now. Crikey, we're long. Yeah, we're good. That's the tray, the platform coming up. So basically we can just run ourselves down, but this whole train has got so much momentum that it could push me on at 20 odd kilometers an hour. Yeah. I'm going to overrun. Oh shit, I'm going to overrun. How do you slow down? I'm going to overrun. Game over. Game over. I'm going to overrun. I'm going to overrun. I'm going to overrun. Oh. Stop. Oh. Huh. Alrighty. That was kind of... I've gone past by that much. Do you think I'm allowed to back up a little bit? Alrighty. I don't know if I'm supposed to do that, but I did it anyway. Whew. I was fully sure I was in trouble there. Now, we are departing at 36 here, so we've got a good 4.5 minutes plus to wait around. It is really so much better without that HUD on the screen.